Sorry, do we have similar whistling or?
Yes, Alexei told me that the seminar will be on the using this link, and Alexei will be host. I will make him host, mm-hmm. and he will run the seminar. So I believe that I have to upload the same Blackboard. Okay. I will send to everybody the link to the Blackboard. Ah, Alexey, you're here. Great. So let me send. If some new participant will join us, just please send Alexey, please send him the link to the Blackboard. I will just send it right now. So here it is. And I will make Alexey the host. I will give so share screen. Yes, and. So Alexey, you are now allowed to share screen, and one moment, I'll try to make you host. Make host, yes. You are now Alexey, you're host.
Thank you. I just wanted to ask if the next lectures are going to be online also.
I plan to make second lecture in mixed mode. I'm planning to be present in person in the lecture room, and I will ask the administration of the faculty to change the schedule as we agreed with everybody to 11:20, and I will keep you informed about what was decided.
Yeah, please do.
Yes.
I also like to make seminars in the mixed mode because I have some problems with my tablet to hold seminars entirely online, it's kind of a problem.
Yes, it would be better to use mixed mode. I believe
of course,
so.
Yes.
So
in that case, probably someone should organize the video. I don't know.
So Alexey, I suggest the following. So when you do seminar, you just record. Or just, yes, actually what happens is that I think I'm recording, the session is recorded automatically, yes? My question is the following. I don't know how the things how are the things? Because in my screen, there is recording sign. And my question is the following. Is it true that the new host will host the recording? Or it's me who will host the recording?
I'm not sure.
Just please let me know. Alexey, try to convert the recording in the MP4 format. And just please tell me whether you had an access to this. If not, then the system will record to my computer. Just we will check this, just experimentally.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay, I believe that there should be some break, and then Alexey will start seminar when just at appropriate time.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I will just leave you for a moment. Just you please feel free to go ahead without me. I will just participate to the seminar with a bit, but I will be a bit late. But please don't wait for me, just start without me.
Okay.
Okay. So Alexey, just please try to share the Blackboard with everybody. Please try to open the Blackboard and to share it with everybody else. I believe that there should be some new participant. And when you start the seminar, please just send again the link to the Blackboard. And the system works like this. When you send, if you share the screen and send the link to the Blackboard simultaneously in the chat, it doesn't arrive. So to in order to to send some the link to everybody, you have to disconnect to cancel screen sharing. Then you send the link, and then you again start a screen sharing. Then this works. This works. Okay, so see you a bit later. That's
Sorry, what's the time of the beginning?
Yeah, but we're supposed to begin just right now. So I sent a file with seminar problems, which you also see on the screen.
So we are we solving problem one?
Sorry, I have some problems writing on my touchpad. So let me just.
So, Alexei, have you started the seminar?
Yeah, I'm trying, but I have problems writing on my touchpad, so I don't really know how do I write. So I'm supposed to write on the blackboard. What do I do exactly?
Yes, please write on the blackboard. Yes. Have you shared the screen with everybody? Everybody can see the blackboard?
I can see from this end.
Okay, so Alexei, can you write down on the blackboard? Do you have the tools? Okay.
Okay, so let's start with problem 1A. This is to find the convergence domain of a power series. Which is given like this. Z1 squared plus 4Z2 squared. To the power k. So can you see what I write here?
Yes, I can.
Thank you. Because it's a little bit, yeah. Mm-hmm. So if a power series is given like this, we have to find the convergence domain.
Alexei, excuse me. So in the bracket, the square power of that two is not seen. Can you just draw it? The mark. Yes, that's it. Thank you.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So we can consider that all Z1 and Z2 are real positive numbers because we can acts on them by torsion. So, and as they are positive, it is equivalent that k multiplied by this variable modulus z1 square plus 4z2 square that this series converges, and it converges when W, I mean, this expression in brackets, is less than one. So it will be.
Okay, what you suggest to do is to just replace this by.
Is it true?
So the first we have to check that this is an inequality which indeed describes convergence domain, and we have to check that it is indeed the convergence domain.
I think I explained, but we can replace it one and the two by its modulus, and it converges if and only if the
yes.
sequence
converges.
And yes. Because yes. All the coefficients are positive,
yes,
we can group them and to look at such
yes.
Series.
Exactly. Yes, that's correct. Absolutely correct. Yes, because for positive number convergence is equivalent to convergence of series with positive number with just this. And this converges if only if we have this inequality. And by rotational invariance, convergence at a given point is equivalent to convergence at the same point where the components are replaced by moduli. And that's it. That's the answer. Yes, thank you. Yes, so let's pass to the next problem.
Sure. So the next problem is sorry, just a moment. The same question is to find the convergence domain of the power series. To the power minus k. Here we have z1, z2. Plus to the Q, to the third power, to the K.
The same argument shows that we need this expression be with modulus be less than two. One over two.
Less than two or one over two?
One half.
Less than one half. Do you mean that well half, one half is it necessary to ask one half or?
I mean the radius of convergence of W, I mean in this brackets, it is one over two.
I don't agree.
You have here.
2 minus k, so it's 2. Oh, okay.
Yes, the radius of conversion, if you replace the inside of brackets by w, by one variable w, then the convergence radius will be 2. So if the expression in brackets is replaced by w, which has modulus less than 2, then the series converges. It's clear. But what about a convergence domain of the series in 3 variables?
Think it should be like that.
That's true. And the argument is this basically is exactly the same.
Yeah.
Because the whole issue is positivity of all the coefficients here and there and whatever. The argument exactly the same. So, and let us go to the next problem, problem 1C.
Ali Virkai asked in the chat to repeat this argument.
Okay. To repeat the previous, so the argument is the following. We know that the convergence domain should be invariant under counter-coordinate bias rotations. And therefore, the convergence at a given z is equivalent to convergence to the same z where the coordinates are positive, are rotated to be positive, where the coordinates are equal to moduli of, of coordinates. And but if you suppose that z1 and z2 and z3 are positive numbers, then all the if you expand this series as a Taylor series as a sum of monomials, then all the terms of the series will be positive. And therefore, if a series has positive coefficients, then its convergence is independent on the choice of order of sum in order. And in particular, its convergence is equivalent to convergence of the series where we first calculated this power k and then multiplied by 2 power minus k, etc. Yes. If we, so convergence of this Taylor series with positive z1 and z2, z3 is equivalent to convergence of the new series, which obtained is obtained as follows. First, we substitute z1 and the positive z1, z2, and z3. Here, we calculate this expression in the bracket, take its power k, and we do this operation for each k, and then we sum up what we get. The convergence of this series is equivalent to the convergence of the series with expanded, expanded as a sum of monomials. Because if we have a positive series with positive coefficients, its convergence is independent on choice of order of summing. Because there will be no cancellation. And in phrase, this means that for but if the z1, z2, z3 are positive, then convergence of this new series is equivalent to the equality, to the inequality that this expression in the bracket is less than one. And that's all about convergence for positive Z1 and Z2, Z3. But for no, but for non-positive, the answer will be the same as if we replaced each coordinates by its modulus. So Ali, is it okay?
Yes, thank you.
Okay, let's go to the next problem, which is the following. We're given a function, given a rational function. The following form. Plus 2 times z2. Okay, so the question is to find the Taylor series expansion of this function at the origin.
Yes, so the question is the following. You first, what is it true that the, so for finds convergence domain for the Taylor series of this function? So actually, to find the Taylor series, the coefficients, it's this will be just rather big formulas. Is the problem is not to calculate the Taylor series explicitly.
Yeah. Sorry.
So it is possible eventually, but it takes some time. The problem is to find convergence domain.
Yeah, so we need to find the convergence domain, and the function is given by this formula.
So it seems that it is modulo z1 plus 2 modulo z2 is less than 1, but now it is not so clear.
It is. It seems that it should be a necessary condition, but we have to prove this, and we have to check out whether to check whether we don't need an extra condition.
I think it's sufficient condition.
So the modulus of Z1 plus to Z2 less than one, yes? Yes, it seems that may, yes, it seems that it's sufficient condition. And just please let us explain that it is sufficient and let us check whether it is necessary.
So it is sufficient because square root of 1 plus x has 1 to be radius of convergence.
Yeah, that's true. And for if you just study the convergence of the Taylor series of the square root of the square root, for the previously seen reasons of positivity of coefficients, etc., by the way, here you will not have positive coefficients, but but still convergence of at a given z is if z belongs to a convergence domain of this square root above is equivalent to the same statement with z1 z2 replaced by the modulus because of invariance of domain of convergence domain. But if you take if you consider z1 and z2 are positive, then the convergence of the Taylor series for the square root above is equivalent to the inequality you have stated, to the inequality modulus z1 plus 2 modulus z2 less than 1. That's for convergence of this square root. But the question is the following. We have just a ratio of square root here and something below. If the series of the expression above is bad, it diverges, can this divergence be annihilated by behavior of the denominator or not? Or these are two independent issues?
So maybe we can always replace coefficients by the modulus by Cauchy-Adamar formula. So the previous arguments works here too, is it?
Because now, if you just the problem is that when you write down Taylor's formula for square root 1 plus x, square root of 1 plus x, then there will be negative coefficients which will appear. The binomial coefficients of degree 1 over half, they become negative. They can become just changing sign from certain moment. But we can rule out the situation by Cauchy-Adamar formula.
No, I'm not so sure because maybe they can some coefficients can shrink.
Yes, they can cancel out. Yes, that's true. A priori, some coefficients may cancel out. A priori. But still, the question is the following. So I agree with you that if you take z1 of z and z2 such that modulus of z1 plus modulus of 2 modulus of z2 is less than 1, then one can easily show that the series of the root square root above converges and even absolutely converges. One can easily show this, it's nothing special. By a kind of similar argument to the previous one, but something with some more precision. What about the denominator? The denominator, so 1 over z plus 1 plus z1, it can be expressed by Taylor series 1 minus z1 plus z1 squared minus et cetera, et cetera. And this has Taylor convergence radius 1. But if you have inequality modulus z1 plus 2 modulus z2 less than 1, then modulus z1 is definitely less than 1. And we live in the and both series converge, the series for the square root above and the series for 1 over 1 plus z1. So this is sufficient condition for convergence, this inequality. But is it a necessary condition? Is it true that if the inequality is not satisfied, then the point in question does not belong to the convergence domain? To this end, it is enough to check the following. If a point Z is such that the inequality that modulus z1 plus 2 modulus z2 is greater than 1, then there is no chance that the series converges.
Maybe if modulus z1 in this case, if also modulus z1 is less than 1, we have a product of two series, one of which yes. converges and one of yes. which diverges. So
yes.
Yes, so we need to check it if z1 modulus z1 is greater than 1, but in this case, this diverges.
Mm-hmm.
So can I say it again? Which condition we need to check that?
So we need to check the following. Suppose we have that the modulus of z2 1 plus z plus 2 modulus z2 is greater than 1.
Yeah, sure.
Then we have to check that the series will diverge.
Mm-hmm.
If we do this, then everything is done. But in fact, what happens is the following. If the series, we know that the series converges uniformly on compact domains in the convergence domain. And therefore, the series should represent a function holomorphic on the convergence domain.
Correct.
Yes.
So the square root is not holomorphic if this is minus one.
Yes, yes, the root will be not holomorphic. The root will be not holomorphic at the point where z1 plus 2z2 equals to minus 1. If z1 plus 2z2 is equal to minus 1, the root will be not holomorphic. And it will be, yes, and one can ask the question whether non-holomorphicity of this root can be cancelled by some bad behavior of the denominator. Of the denominator, the answer is I think the answer is no. It can be cancelled. So one can describe those points where this function is definitely has no chance to be holomorphic. For example, the line that one plus two z two is equal to minus one, along this line, no chance to have holomorphicity. Except maybe the point where z1 equals to 1, but this will be just exceptional point of this line. It does not match. The point is if you take the punctured line, z1 plus 2z2 equals to minus 1, punctured at z1 equals to 1, then along this line, no holomorphicity. This line cannot be contained in the convergence domain. And therefore, a convergence domain is such a domain that is invariant under the torus action and which is just disjoint from this line. It is disjoint from this line and therefore it is disjoint from the images of this line under all the rotation, coordinate wise rotations. Maybe this can help.
So is it just the origin?
What is the origin?
The domain of convergence is just the origin?
No. We have already checked that if the modulus z1 plus 2 modulus z2 is less than, strictly less than 1, then we have convergence. And then the whole domain defined by the inequality modulo Z1 plus 2 modulo Z2 is less than 1, the whole this domain is lies in the domain of convergence. And we would like to check that that the convergence domain is not bigger than that.
Or otherwise, we can multiply and get minus 1, Z1 plus 2, Z2 to be minus 1.
Exactly. That's whole issue. That's the only issue. Because if Z1 plus Z plus 2 Z2 has modulus greater than, if modulus Z1 plus 2 modulus Z2 is greater than 1, then one can multiply Z1 and Z2 by appropriate constant in order to get that Z1 plus 2 Z2 is equal to be equal to minus 1. And that's the end of story. For example, if just a complex number has modulus, which has modulus greater than 1, just how to say this properly. One moment. So if you have that modulus Z1 plus 2 modulus Z2 greater than 1, then we would like to make coordinate wise rotation in order to get the number Z1 plus 2 modulus Z2 be equal to minus 1. And I claim it's possible. Because what happens is the following. You can just multiply the number. Yes, I claim it is one moment. One has to check something. I claim that if that modulus Z1 plus 2 modulus Z2 is equal to 1, if it is equal to 1, then definitely one can apply coordinate vice rotation in order to make Z1 plus 2 Z2 being equal to minus 1. And therefore, the set modulus Z1 plus 2 modulus Z2 equal to 1 does not lie in the convergence domain. That's definitely true. And I believe that from this one can deduce that the inequality below defines the true convergence domain.
Yeah. So if you take a point on the boundary and you apply a composition of coordinate by rotation, you take this point to the point minus one where convergence definitely fails. That's what you are saying, right?
Yes, exactly. Yes. So I am saying that on no point, if you no point lying on the set where Z1 modulus Z1 plus 2 modulus Z2 equals 1, no point there can be a point of in convergence domain. And I claim even more. Suppose we have, may I write down somewhere, in the blackboard. I will try to write down the same blackboard. One moment, where it is. One moment. I'm looking for the blackboard, I'm not finding it. So here it is. I will arrive just shortly. I don't know what is wrong with my blackboard, but this doesn't open. It doesn't open. Here it is. Yes, Here it is. But the problem is that I don't see how to, can I draw anything? Ah, here it is. So if I let me check, if I draw something here, can you see this? Not?
I think you need to find the place on the blackboard where I'm writing.
Ah, okay.
So everyone sees.
Oh, okay. One moment. One moment, I am trying to get your place. I don't arrive. Okay, Alexey, you can just write down what I am saying. So first point that if you consider the set defined by the equality modulus Z1 plus 2 modulus Z2 equals 1, the set cannot lie in the convergence domain. Because applying coordinate-wise rotation, we can arrive to a point where the function is not holomorphic. While the function should be holomorphic in the convergence domain. It's first point to be stated.
So this...
Points like this do not lie in convergence domain.
They said does.
Yes.
Does not.
Yes. Second point is the following. We have crossed out already from the convergence domains the points satisfying this equality. But we have to cross out the points satisfying inequality, that modulus Z2 plus that is not modulus Z1 plus 2 modulus Z2 is greater than 1. And to cross out these points is easy. Suppose we have a point where modulus Z of Z1 plus 2 modulus Z2 is greater than 1.
Yeah, then we just apply.
And suppose this point lies in the convergence domain. Suppose to the contrary that this point lies in the convergence domain.
Mm-hmm.
Then we apply Abel's lemma. We apply Abel's lemma, which yields a convergence of the series in a polydisk. In a polydisk, this corner point being our point. So let us denote by R the vector of modulus Z1, modulus Z2, and I claim that the polydisk delta R lies in the convergence domain by Abel's lemma. So modulus Z1 and modulus Z2.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, and I claim that delta R, the polydisk delta R, lies in the convergence domains by Abel's lemma. Delta capital. I am denoted by delta capital R. Delta capital.
Okay.
Sorry. Okay. Okay. Let's go. Okay. We consider this the delta capital. Okay. So then we know that this polydisk lies in the convergence domain by Abel's lemma. By Abel's lemma, and since R in question, light in the complete convergence domain. Yes, it lies in omega. But look, the polydisc delta R lies in omega. Therefore, the polydisc delta lambda R lies in omega for any lambda less than one.
So can you say it again?
Yes, this disk polydisk lies in omega for any lambda less than one. Mm-hmm. And now let us choose lambda such that lambda R1 plus 2 lambda R2 be equal to 1. No, sorry. I would like to say the following. Sorry. I would like to say that this polydisc, the conclusion is the following, that the polydisc delta R contains a point R prime such that R prime 1 plus 2 R prime 2 is equal to 1.
Okay, so the polydisc.
So the polydisc delta R contains a point R prime, which is some lambda times R, for which R prime 1 plus 2 R prime 2 is equal to 1.
Such that
R prime 1 plus 2 R prime 2 is equal to 1. And this R prime can be just taken as a multiple, as a constant positive multiple of R with some lambda less than one. And what we get, we obtained a new point R prime, which lies in the domain of convergence, which cannot lie in the domain of convergence because R prime 1 plus 2 R prime 2 equals 1. We know that if R prime 1 plus 2 R prime 2 equal 1, then R prime cannot lie in the domain convergence domain. We have checked it already by non-holomorphicity. But on the other hand, our construction yields at such an R prime, which lives in the convergence domain. The contradiction thus obtained shows that no R with R1 plus R2 R2 greater than 1 can live in the convergence domain. And no Z with modulus Z1 plus two modulus Z2 greater than 1, know that like this can live in the convergence domain. And this finishes the proof that the convergence domain in question coincides with the domain given by inequality. Modulus Z1 plus 2 modulus Z2 is less than 1. And that's the end of story.
Okay, there is also a problem. Problem B is for homework.
Problem D, yes, let us leave it for problem D for homework.
Similar to the one we just discussed.
Yes.
Okay, so the next problem is to find the Taylor series.
Yes.
The origin of a given function.
Yes.
So let me write down the first function.
Okay, but I will just send to everybody the seminar task just, by email to make sure. Just
I've shared this file here in Zoom, but
not everybody got it.
Yeah, okay.
I will just send it to everybody.
So we have function 1 over the product of 1 minus z. Where I is from 1 to n.
Yes, I have sent right now.
Thank you.
Okay, in all these exercises, we just can open brackets.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, pretty much. Yes, I have a product of functions.
That's true, yes.
Yeah, and then you just need to put the monomials in some in a proper order.
Mm-hmm.
K belongs to what?
It's
K is integer vectors with non-negative integer components.
It should be
Zn is sub greater or equal to zero.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yes, that's right.
So next is similar, just change of variables. So I think we
exactly. That's nothing special. Yes, and so in the second exercise we will get the same, but what will be the coefficients at that power k? Yes. This is yes. That's true. Okay, and let us consider. Let us pass to the number 2C. the problem to see with logarithms.
So in the problem 2c, we have just the product of logarithms.
Mm-hmm.
Product. Where I is from 1 to n.
Mm-hmm. In complex analysis, it is better to avoid using indices I, because I is minus is square root of minus 1. It is better to say j or some other letter.
Okay, let it be k.
Mm-hmm. Okay, is our multi-index okay? It's up to you. Maybe L, maybe J. It's up to you.
This is true.
So minus one power.
Oh, where should be product of k.
Minus one power n. Okay. Okay. Mm-hmm. Can you spell what is in the product below?
It is a product of elements of K.
Product of elements.
Okay, K is that.
Okay. That's true. Thank you. Yes, it sounds, yes, it's correct. Well, now let us treat the problem 2D, the last one.
Yeah, so the last one is the exponent of exponent of the sum of all the variables. One plus Yeah, so here we're just
Okay, so okay, so the modulus of k factorial below and c of k by n of n. Sorry,
I maybe it's wrong notation. I mean multi binomial coefficient. So it's modulo k factorial divided by the product of factorials.
So above near z power k is a product of factorials of components of k, yes?
Yes.
So
it's a multinomial coefficient. So we take the factorial of the modulus of k and divide by the product of factorials of each individual component.
That's it. Okay. So I believe
that's the way I understand it.
Okay, then I have an impression that the modulus of k factorial cancels out, yes? Because below you have the modulus of factorial, and above you have modulus of factorial, yes? Can you just simplify this expression? I believe that something can be cancelled here.
Okay, I don't know why you don't see that.
Yes, that's it. Yes, exactly. Mm-hmm. Exactly, yes, that's it. That's correct answer. So, thank you. And now next, do we have still time? I believe that you will easily find partial derivative of all this stuff at the origin. Let me pass to suggest you to solve problem number four, which requires less calculations. Problem number four.
Yeah, so we have a Taylor series at the origin, which is given by KN Z1 to the K Z2 to the n.
Mm-hmm.
And k and n go from 1 to infinity.
Yes.
And we need to find a function such that this power series is the Taylor series of this
yes.
function
mm-hmm.
at the origin.
Yes.
So this is a product of two similar functions, sum of k z to k.
Yes.
And this looks like one over one minus so it can be found by a derivative of the one plus z square and so on multiply by z, so it will be minus z over it will be z over one minus z and square of it.
Can you just please write it down? Yes, it sounds correct, but just please write it down. Okay, so if you take this, then this is this is the derivative of this is the derivative of one over one minus z. This derivative times z one. That's it. Yes, that's correct. And the whole issue is the following: if you take the series sum of k times z power k, like this, in one variables. In one variable, that is the same as z times the derivative of the series z one plus z plus z square plus z cubed, etc., etc. As the derivative of the series is nothing else but just the derivative of one of one minus z one. And if you calculate its derivative, the derivative will be one over one minus z one z square. And you will have to multiply it by z again. And this is a whole issue, because just to look at the coefficients, we can check that it is product of two derivatives times z1 and z2. And that's it. And the derivatives in the equation are the derivative of 1 over 1 minus z, and the other derivative is z1, and the other derivative is z1 is the derivative of the function of one of one minus z2. That's it. Thank you. So I believe that our time is over.
Yeah.
Yes. And actually, we have missed problem three, but it is can be done as easy calculation, also as homework. Yes. So Alexey, so thank you and thanks to everybody. So and let us try to make our class in mixed mode next time.
Yeah, I hope that
yes,
that there will be a translation to Zoom.
Yes,
it definitely is going to be more convenient.
Yes, that's true.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
See you next time.
See you.